relax.
Hi, folks.
Oh!
Oh, my God.
Dr. Thakkar
in the house. Thank you.
Honey, yeah. Is he really here, or is this just a dream?
We've been waiting for a while. Can you tell?
So we are constantly playing the role of therapist at the same time that we're playing the role of a physician.
I can see you guys are really frustrated, and I really want to apologize, but I'm here now, and I'd like to help you. So if we could get started, you could tell me what's going on.
Yes, okay. Well, for a few weeks, I've had a lot of terrible pain down here. It's just been getting worse, and now there's this strange discharge.
Yeah, we raised the force field, if you know what I mean, around it.
But stop.
Patients come to the emergency room. They're usually a little bit more reserved when it concerns topics of a sexual nature, but this couple happened to be very open.
We haven't had sex in 3 weeks.
Are you having any other symptoms with that? Any pelvic cramping, any high fever, nausea, vomiting, anything else I need to be aware of?
No.
Okay. As the wife is telling me about her symptoms, noticing the husband doesn't appear to be well. He's clearing his throat, he's coughing.
Are you okay, sir? You seem to be sick as well.
No, it's just a lingering cough from a bug. Right, otherwise, I'm the picture of perfect health.
Okay, doctor, can we work on fixing me?
We have to do a pelvic exam so we can take some tests so we can figure out what's going on.
When a patient is having pelvic pain, we worry about different types of pelvic infections, whether it be a simple sexually transmitted disease or something more serious. Pelvic exams have a huge role as far as determining how serious that infection, if they have one in the pelvic area, is.
Okay, well, do what you gotta do. I just gotta get this fixed.
Okay.
And sometime today would be great. We'll get lives.
I'll be right back.
Okay. Be right back, please.
Yes, I will.
Pelvic exams are never done in the exam room alone.
Kate, can you join me for a pelvic exam in room one, please? Yeah, you mind? Okay, great.
As I left the room, she had made an excuse to her husband and came out into the hallway and really was frantic at that point. It was a different person.
Doctor, look, the discomfort has become so strong that I have totally lost interest in all my bedroom activities.
I mean, it's not like it matters. My husband never wants to have sex with me anyway.
If a patient approaches me and they're confiding in me, we don't typically have conversations in the middle of the hallway.
Diana, can we please talk about this in your room, not in the middle of the hallway?
No. I know my husband is cheating on me. I mean, how else would you explain this infection that's going on down here?
This woman was a little bit more honest than most, but initially you're always shocked at what people will say to you. They will come clean because they know that their diagnosis may depend on them being honest.
Will I even know if I have an STD?
STDs are sometimes figured out in the emergency room, not always, but we'll only know once we do the pelvic exam. So can we please take this back into the room? Let's do the exam, okay? I'll meet you in there.
Let's go do that pelvic exam.
All right, let's go.
As I was doing the pelvic exam on this woman, my nurse, Katie, he suddenly left the room.
Nurse?
Doctor, what's going on?
Now I have no chaperone in the room. And I'm thinking, okay, now what?
I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to stop. We need a chaperone in here,
so
I'm sorry.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Chaperone?
I'll be right
back. Is this a school dance?
What did you do to me? Even they're walking.
Wait, are you blaming on me now?
Katie, are you okay?
I'm so sorry, doctor. It was either get sick in there or get sick out here.
Katie ran out of the room because she's 4 months pregnant, and she suddenly became sick.
Looks like this pregnancy is really kicking your butt. I'll get somebody else in the room to join me for the pelvic exam, okay?
Doctor. Is my wife going to be okay?
What? Sir, we didn't get far enough in the exam to know if she's doing fine or not, but now that you're out here, I did want to discuss something with you.
I started thinking about the husband with his cough and throat clearing and his limp.
I saw you limping in the room, and I see your throat's bothering you.
But what's with other questions? Is it me or her you're seeing? What's going on here?
Even though she's the patient right now, I'd like to see if you wouldn't mind checking in yourself.
Why?
I'm afraid the infection she has may be an infection that you have as well.
She gave me something?
Once the patient told me that there's a possibility of her husband having cheated on her, then I started thinking of different types of sexually transmitted diseases.
It's a pretty serious limp I noticed you had out there. Everything okay with your leg?
Yeah, I heard it playing water polo a few weeks ago. It's no big deal.
Well, let's take a look at your throat, okay, and see if you need to have any cultures done, okay?
This gonorrhea can cause a very severe throat infection. If it gets into the bloodstream, can seed into the joint, and they can get an infection in the joint called a septic arthritis.
Yeah, Well, you look like, you know, it could be strep or mono, but we just gotta make sure with this culture to make sure that there's nothing more serious going on back there.
I became even that much more concerned that he may have contracted a sexually transmitted disease and now is passing it off to his wife.
Here's the test results you ordered.
All right, well, great news, sir. You're right, you do just have a common cold.
Ah, genius, doctor.
What did he do?
Hey.
I was surprised because his rapid gonorrhea test came back negative. So although it seemed like all our ducks were lined up in a row for this man to have a nice, neat, and tidy diagnosis of gonorrhea in his throat, sometimes we start overthinking things when we see certain patterns in an emergency room.
That's good news for once.
We're here for me.
Go on.
All right. Yeah, you have a pretty significant infection going on here for sure.
Mm-hmm. What is that?
I'm in the middle of this pelvic exam and I see something glistening in the corner of her cervix and I was like, what is in there?
There's definitely something there.
What?
You know, we all would like to think that the vagina is filled with nerve fibers that let the woman feel everything that they can feel, but the probability of a woman noticing that there's something left up there is actually very low.
I'll need some more light.
What is that?
What is what? What the heck is that?
And it was an old condom. As I pulled this condom out, his eyeballs came bulging out of his head.
Doctor, I haven't used a condom in 5 years. Since my vasectomy, what the hell is going on here?
Okay, just because he found a condom doesn't mean anything.
Doesn't mean anything? What, so it just curled up there by itself?
When I pulled out the condom, in a way it was a sense of relief because of the answer, and it was less serious than I expected of like toxic shock syndrome from a foreign body being in the vagina for too long. So technically, this is good news.
Why am I getting the blame? He just found a condom that's not mine, and you're blaming me?
So she was quickly treated with antibiotics.
Okay, you know what? That's it.
What, are you gonna fight me now?
Yes, I am. Oh, maybe I just wanna get rid of you.
The fact that this woman was brazen enough to accuse her husband of cheating when she fully well knows that she has been cheating was the real surprise in all of this.
That's you.